You. It is working, yes. So I'll present a joint work with my advisors, Alessandro Ruggia and Francis Back, on exponential convergence of testing error for stochastic gradient descent. So I guess that now you're all familiar with stochastic gradient descent. I recall two or three things. So it minimizes a function f given access to when you have only access to unbiased gradient estimates. So this is a workhorse in machine learning because it has very low complexity per iteration. And then, as Nicola recalled, the best convergence rates are O of 1 over square root of n when the function big F is convex, and O of 1 over n when it's stringly convex. So the main question that is tackled by our paper is the following. Can it be faster for classification problems? So, and I'll spoil it directly. The take-home message that yes, stochastic gradient descent converges exponentially fast in classification error if we add some margin condition. So what is the problem setting? The problem setting is a very standard binary classification problem. When you've got your data x and which is the input and the output y can be either minus 1 or 1, so that our prediction can be parameterized by the sign of a certain function g of x, when g of x can be written as the inner product in some feature space of g, the parameter on which we are going to optimize, and phi of x, a feature vector of our data. So, and what we want is to minimize over g the classification error, which is basically that you're penalized by 1 each time g of x is not the correct sign. So as you all know, this classification error is not convex. So what people use, what people do usually, is that they use square loss, convex surrogates. And in this talk and in the paper, we used the square loss. So two notations. So I'm going to call G star here the minimum of the test loss, I mean for the error for the square loss, which is the expectation of y given x, and g lambda, the same thing, the minimum, but with respect to the same problem, but with a regularization parameter lambda. So you can see that g lambda is some smoothing of g star here. And why this is not stupid to consider excess losses with respect to the square loss instead of error? First, because it's convex, and second, because we have some control. Bartlett and Al showed that you have some control of the excess error if you can control the excess loss. So the transfer function here is the square root. So this is not a bad idea a priori to consider the excess losses if we want to bound the excess error. But if we use existing results for SGD, like the excess error, as the excess error goes to zero as 1 over n, the excess error, the classification error, is goes to zero only as 1 over square root of n. So those are not the exponential rates that I was talking about. So how do we do that? First, we add some assumptions, some a priori on the distribution of the x's. And this is called some margin condition. This has been introduced by Mamen and Sibakov in 1999. And it relies on the fact that there are some hard inputs. There are some inputs that are harder to predict to others. And more precisely, those are the inputs for which the probability that y is 1 is the same that the probability that y is minus 1. And in this point, the optimal predictor, the expectation of y given x, is 0. This is an easy computation. So that what we want to do is to move away from these hard inputs to predict, so that our strong, and this is a strong margin condition, is to bound away from 0 the absolute value of the optimal predictor. And you can picture this in 1D by saying that if we consider the sign of this function, then the spaces, the subspaces where it's positive and negative are separated by a zone where the distribution has no mass. So this is our strong margin condition. And I'll add another technical condition that says basically that we have the same condition but on the smoothing of G star, G lambda. G lambda has to be bounded away from zero and is an optimal prediction of our problem. So the picture here in 1D is the same. And the consequence of these two assumptions is that if we have an estimator J hat close enough in L infinity norm of G lambda, then it will be an optimal predictor because it would have the right sign. So, and this is what we achieved by going single pass for the stochastic gradient descent algorithm for the regularized problem. If we consider the tail average estimator, which is simply the average over the n over 2 last iterates of our stochastic gradient descent, then we can show that the classification error for this estimator goes exponentially fast with respect to the number of samples. So two or three comments for the main result. First, as I said earlier, it relies heavily on the high probability bound in the L infinity norm for the SGD recursion, which is itself can be considered as a result on its own because the previous results were often in the L2 norm. Yes, I just recall that the excess testing loss the loss with respect to the square loss is not exponentially convergent. The regression problem still goes to zero as 1 over n. And yes, I'd like to give some motivation to look at the paper or to come at the poster session. We have sharper bound with respect to lambda. We bounded the thing for regular averaging and not only the tail averaging. And we have bounds for general low noise condition. But in fact, for low noise condition, the rates are not exponential, but they are still faster than 1 over n. So we can discuss that if you go at the poster. And finally, to illustrate the talk, some synthetic experiments here to show the difference of behavior between the excess losses and the excess errors. I plot here. This is a log-log plot, so showing 1 over n decrease of the excess loss. And this is here a semi-log plot, so showing a line would be an exponential decrease with respect to the number of samples. So in conclusion, I mean the take-home message has not changed. It's still that if you assume some margin condition, then you can have exponential convergence of the test error and not the test loss. And possible extension, I mean, when we looked at the experiments, the synthetic experiments, there were no need of the regularization parameter, so maybe this is one way, and we could go beyond least squares, look at all the things. So thank you for your attention, and come see us at the poster session. Yes. We don't have an assumption like that, actually, I think. But if we assume that, then our second technical assumption is useless. I mean, we can show this technical assumption if you assume that the optimal predictor is in the class of problem you consider. So this has to do with the regularity of your problem.
Okay, let's thank the speaker again.